Hi, I'm Pierre-Neuve and today we're going to be troubleshooting and fixing this Toshiba A100. So let's see what it does when we plug in the power supply and power is on. Here we have the power button. So when I press it, the screen activates but nothing else happens except that we have the power LED lighting up, but it's dim. So let's remove the screen and see what we get here. So let's try this again. We plug in the charger. Some power LED lights up, but it's dim too. And when I press the power button, here it doesn't even turn on anymore. So let's unplug this. Where do we start here? There's no apparent damage to the motherboard, everything looks fine, no water damage, no nothing. So first let's remove the RAM sticks. Oop, here we go. And it's doing exactly the same with fan and spin. So let's see which voltage do we get on this motherboard. The thing we are interested in might be on the user side. Yep, charger area. Power gets in here. So the plug we should be getting somewhere around 15 volts, and as you can read on the multimeter we have 50 volts on this coil. We're getting nothing, probably the battery. Not really sure. On the fuse we get 15 volts too. Current sense resistor 15. So the input is fine. Let's see the other coil here. Nothing. 3.3 volts, that's nice. Should be getting 3.3 and 5 volts somewhere else. So here we have the standby 3.3 volts. Nothing on this one. And there's a bunch of other coils on the other side of the motherboard. The CPU, we are not interested in this because it doesn't even turn on correctly. This one, nothing. And we are getting 3 volts here. That's not something I would accept. So not sure if it's the 5 volt standby voltage or not, but if it is, we have got an issue right here. So let's look at the schematics and see what it says. to play. Maybe that's not what I wanted to do. Here we go. The schematic right here. So we are looking at this stuff. And on the board, this coil is marked here we go, A1, and C21, C20, so this is the 5V area, which doesn't output 5V. So the first thing we are gonna do is unplug the power and see if we have gotten short to ground and output. So let's switch to home mode. Okay, let's remove this. So let's measure on the coil directly. And seems like it's hot. Let's see. Yeah, we're charging a capacitor, not sure, but it's not a shorter one, we have a few kilo ohms, should be okay. So we have got an issue in the creation side. So let's switch back to the schematics. It's this one, the drain is probably the left side, so let's the voltage, plug the charger in, and here we go, 15 volts in the drain. Oh, sorry, this is the one, wait, 15. And yep, so that's your output to the coil, and there, here we have ground. What do we get on the gate? 3V. 3V on the gate and 3V on the drain doesn't look right. The other one is 0. Okay, 3V. 3V, yeah. And if we measure the voltage between the gate and the source, we get 0. So, might be the issue right here. A short between the gate and the source. Let's measure that in home mode. We are still on Q4, drain to source, sorry, gate to source. And we have got 1.3 ohms, which is way, way, way too low. So this transistor is probably fucked up, so let's remove it and see what we get. I'm gonna do this with the iron. It's my hotel, this complete shit. So let's do the iron right here. Add some flux, complete sheet flux, but well, it does the job too. Add some solder. Well, tweezers and pull this MOSFET off. Here we go. Weak source pads. Yeah, my iron is a complete shit too. Don't even handle this old Toshiba board. Up. Here you go. But we are going to fix that later. I just want to measure if the short is gone. Let's see if we are still there. Is the short gone? No, it's not. So this MOSFET was probably fine. Let's test it by itself. Let's see if he does have a short or not. Clean it up a little bit. Here we go. Okay, so MOSFET, are you okay? Hey, you are okay, so let's put you back there because you are not our problem right here. Clean the pads up. Here we go. Add some flux. The transistor back on and solder it. Push down. This gate pad looks right. This source pad is a bit going to do the job. My iron isn't heating up enough. Not sure why, but it should be okay. I'm not sure if it's gonna be okay or not. I can't fit up those pods. Yeah. Oh well. That's gonna be fine. Looks like complete shit, but well, what you gonna do? Should be okay. Let's grab some acetone to clean that up. okay. So let's get back to the schematics. Turn that on. No. So let's up right here. Let's plug in the power. And nope. Didn't work. Let's try that again. Let's reload my room. Cool this down right now, and yeah, we got an orange light right here. Oh yeah, here we go, turns on after we heated up this TPS 551, I think, 020. Yeah, so it's probably the culprit right here. So now we are going to replace it. It's as simple as that. Not sure if I should use hot air. Yep, I'll use this. That's some flux. Yep. Should be near enough. And remove the chip. Thank you. skin the pads. Okay, should be enough. Let's get ourselves a chip. Here we go. We've got the spoon right here. Not sure of the orientation. It should be marked on the board, but let's not press this and look at the chip itself, which is this way. Okay, new chip. Ah, fuck. New chip, old chip. Put some flux on the board. Put the new chip here. And we'll be soldering that on its pads. Roughly align it beforehand. Here we go. Get the solder on the iron and solder at least two pads to hold it in place, and same on the other side. Let's solder two pads. Well, not that useful. But well, now pull it down on the chip, and we're gonna solder the other pads like this. If it wants to work, it doesn't, but well, here we go. Not really happy with that, but it should be okay. Let's do the other side. Same shit. Yep, to my shoulder right here. Oh well, it's gonna be okay. Hop. Yeah, not enough solder right now. Well, what you gonna do? Perfection soldering with you. Shit. not aligned properly, so that's why I can't get it to fit. But it's gonna be okay. Well, let's try that again. It doesn't work. It's gonna be my fault. So what do we get? Some shitty dim light as it seems, so I'm not sure what's going on right here. Let's measure the output voltage. And up here, yeah, no, 5.2 volts, so it's perfectly fine. Let's turn it on, and it does turn on. See, fan spins. So we are good to go. It's fixed. Well, before we put everything back in the case, I'm gonna clean that up a little bit. Let's see that. Well, oh, gonna be fine. Let's set on. Let's replace the salt paste because it's an old machine and it probably has never been done. So, and there's the nerve bridge. It seems someone fucked with it already. Let's clean all this mess. it even look like nail paste. Oh well. Yep, looks better. Somebody scratch the die. Yep. Oh, that'll be fine too. Oh. Here we go. Yep. No, yep, no. No dust, fine. So somebody really opened it up not that long ago. Everything back in its housing. Let's fetch everything. First, the bottom part. I don't exactly remember how it goes. If I remember fine, I have to take this out for it to fit. Not sure. We'll see. Oh. Look right. Oh well, it'll be fine. Yep. Going in like this, I think. No, got to put the SATA port before. Yep, like this. Yeah. Okay. Now these ports, audio jacks are in. This doesn't really matter. It's pushing backward beyond. I can't. Yep. Like here. Here we go. I'm not sure what this stuff is. Some flex cable wedge here. Okay. This one goes like that. Okay. Screw those, this stuff. Later. Some other stuff. Hop, Wi-Fi card. Not sure where are the Wi-Fi antennas. Where did I put the tap? No. It's here. No, yeah, well, here. Right here. Wi-Fi antennas are just here. Okay, nice. Some stuff. Not sure. Does it go? Why does this thing goes? Yeah. Oh, yeah, I think there is some sort of... No. No, that's not it. That's not it. Oh, see. See, right here we have got some stuff. I think we are gonna need to remove the keyboard. Oh, first thing first, our power switchboard have to be screwed in back. A set of two screws. Oh, yes. One screw, the other isn't ready. The screw. Said you have to remove the keyboard to actually be able to connect the connectors, so I probably need to unscrew this. Not sure, I'm gonna put it back later. Okay, now keyboard itself. Here we go. Okay, now we can put that back. Do not forget the screw of the motherboard. Which one is it? I don't even remember. I took this apart 1 month ago, I think. So, some small one, maybe this one, maybe the other. Let's see, does it fit in? It does. Okay, let's be this one. And I think it is the only one. Oop. Not sure. Looks like. There's no these other screw right here. Okay. Now for the top. Some flex cable can be put afterwards. Get it. Ah, not sure what the orientation of this stuff is. Top. I think it's. Ah, it's all broken too. Yeah. We'll see. What is this stuff for anyway? But oh, trap pack buttons on one is fucked up. Nice. So it doesn't really matter. Not fixing the trap pack button. Huh? Gonna be fine. So cable goes in like this. Someone messed up with that one already. Gonna go in like this. This flex come like that. In fact, I have access to this flex from the top, so let's just plug it and do it the other way around. Okay. Oops. I hit something, not sure what. 1 cable, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wi-Fi antennas and CD cable. Get out of that. You too. Come on. Here we go. I already lost the other flex. Right here. Not really good with putting those things back together. So this one goes in like that. The other way, okay, like this, go right here. Oh, where are my tweezers? Oh, right here. Okay. Now, let's put the keyboard back on. I'm not gonna screw everything in right now since I'm not sure if everything works. So I'm gonna try putting into an operating system before. And we'll see what we get. Yep. Okay, keyboard is not plugged in. Here we go. Keyboard is plugged in. Okay. Should be okay. I'm gonna put an Ethernet cable right here. Find the Ethernet port. Right here. Charger. There we go. Let's turn this on. Yeah. What is it doing? Doesn't turn on anymore. Fuck. Did I... Oh. Didn't plug in the power button cable. And it's somewhere lost under this laptop cover. I'm gonna have to pop that back out to find it. It's right under here. Ah, fuck. Just like that. Okay, here we go. Unplug the power. anything? Not sure. Oh, here we go. LXDE, desktop environment, left click works, kinda works. Yep, right click works, okay. What do we get? Temperature, sensors. We get 37, perfect. Let's run burn P6. Well, 100% CPU, as you can see, starting to heat up. 54, 51. Yeah, 54, 52. Okay, 55, 52, 53. Okay, perfectly fine. Let's test. What can we test? Sound, I guess. Let's go to YouTube. Oh well. Yep. Not sure if it's gonna work, but let's try. Doesn't work. Doesn't really matter. Okay. So far so good. Let's shut it down and screw everything in. Yeah, there is a fingerprint reader, but I don't care at all about this. Up. Okay, everything's okay under the keyboard. Yep, let's screw the keyboard in. Here we go. Not sure why this is not. Oh well. Not going all the way in doesn't matter. We'll be fine. Now, for the screws. Let's put what I remember and fill the empty space with the users. What did I put there? That's not a B6 through. What the fuck am I doing? Oh well. B6, this one is missing too. Maybe okay. The two right here. Fits in at all. Nice. Why? What the fuck is this shit? What is going on right here? Can't even take it out right now. No. My bad. Left the screw. No hard drive for this machine. Okay, so I got those screws left and they don't belong to anything except those two. Maybe those? Oh, not sure. Sounds like oak. And those two don't. Oh, not sure what's going on. Under here, do we get nothing? Oh, forgot to plug back this little thing. RJ11, I guess. Here we go. No screw under here. Except this. No. Okay. It doesn't really matter, those two screws, I guess. I hope. This stuff is a bit more... Yep, doesn't really want to go back in. That's a bit more concerning. Here we go. Where did I put pretty sure there was some battery pack with it. Oh well, doesn't really matter anyway. Was dead. Must have put it somewhere else. Let's try this again. Ethernet cable, plug that in. Okay. Turn it on. Works. Okay, it's booting and everything looks perfectly fine, except that I can't test the Wi-Fi right now, but that's not an issue. So, shut that down. Well, that's it. So, I hope you learned something. If you get this Toshiba Satellite, not sure how to pronounce that. A100. Seems like that's not the only one to have this issue with the TPS 51020. I've got the exact same one right here. So yeah, I cheated a little bit because I fixed this one off the camera. And as you can see, it works now too. Now this one has got a hard drive in it, a very old Windows XP Media Center edition, I think. So we are gonna see what's working. I mean, so everything is working fine after replacing the sorry, this keyboard is a bit fucked up. Except the keyboard, everything looks perfectly fine to me. Gonna tell the owner to switch to Linux maybe, or use another Windows version instead of this Windows XP. By the way, let's not plug that Ethernet cable in. No, we know at all. Here we go. We are in. Well, nothing really interesting there since this one was already fixed before. But in the end, what I showed you earlier, troubleshooting process, steps and all that stuff, was what I exactly did when I fixed the first one. So, here we go. I hope you learned something again, and see you next time, maybe.